This video will look at variable income statement versus absorption income statement. Okay, all we've done in the past is an absorption income statement. In the condensed version, you see here, sales minus cost of goods sold equals gross profit minus operating expenses equals income from operations. The variable income statement looks a little bit different. It starts with sales, but instead of cost of goods sold, it has variable cost of goods sold, which means it would not include your fixed factory overhead. And sales minus the variable cost of goods sold gives you manufacturing margin. Then you subtract out your other variable costs, your variable operating expenses, to get contribution margin, because remember, sales minus variable cost is contribution margin. You subtract out your fixed costs and you get your income from operations. Looking at them side by side, your sales numbers will be the same either way. You have cost of goods sold here, you have variable cost of goods sold here. You have manufacturing margin, variable operating expenses, contribution margin, fixed costs, where here you just have your operating expenses to get to your income from operations. Using the variable income statement will make a difference on the bottom line of your income statement. If you remember our fixed cost per unit, the more we produce, the less it costs per unit. So we're going to look at some numbers showing why this affects the bottom line using a variable income statement. We'll just have a sample problem here where we're manufacturing 1,000 units and we're only going to sell 800 units. Our costs, our direct materials are $1 per unit, direct labor is 50 cents per unit, variable factory overhead is 50 cents per unit, and fixed factory overhead is $600. Which in the manufacture of 1,000 units, our full capacity, that would be 60 cents per unit. Variable operating expenses are $1 per unit, and fixed operating expenses are $800. So if we sell 800 units at a sales price of $6, let's look at what the two income statements would look like. Here's our problem up here. Okay, under absorption, we're selling 800 units for $6, $4,800 in sales. Our cost of goods sold is going to be $2.60 per unit, $1 for direct materials, 50 cents for direct labor, 50 cents for variable factory overhead, and 60 cents per unit for fixed factory overhead. So 800 units times $2.60, our cost of goods sold is $2,080, giving a gross profit of $2,720. Operating expenses are $1,600. $1 per unit sold, 800 plus 800 fixed is 1600, giving us income from operations of 1120. However, when we do a variable income statement, we're still going to have the same sales. 800 sold at $6 per unit is 4800. But our variable cost of goods sold would not include this 60 cents per unit of factory overhead. So variable cost of goods sold is only $2 per unit times 800 or $1,600. Manufacturing margin is 3,200. Variable operating expenses are $1 per unit times 800, so that's 800. Contribution margin then is 2,400, and our fixed costs are 600 plus 800, $1,400. So our income from operations under the variable is 1,000. There's $120 difference, and where that difference comes in is in the fixed factory overhead per unit. Because we manufactured 1,000 units but only sold 800 units, we had 200 units left in our inventory. Under absorption, we spread this $600 over all these 1,000 units. So the 200 left in inventory would have 60 cents per unit or $120. So instead of that $120 coming out of our costs, is going to still be included as an asset. It's going to still be included in the inventory. However, under variable, we take out the entire fixed costs, treating them just the same as a period cost. So that $120 has come out of the income under the variable system. If you actually sell more than you manufacture by dipping into inventory, then variable is going to have a greater income than absorption. If we use the previous example, only assume that it's the following month and we have similar costs the same the following month. But this time, we only produced 800, but we sold 1,000. So our sales, 1,000 times $6 is 6,000. Cost of goods sold under absorption, well, that first 200 that we sold would be times $2.60. But the 800 that we sold from this month is going to be $2.75 because we only produced 800, so our fixed cost per unit is going to be higher on that graph. And so it comes out to $2.75. So our total cost of goods sold is $27.20, gross profit $32.80, operating expenses $1,800 again, and our income from operations $1,480. Under the variable, sales doesn't change. Variable cost of goods sold, now we have 1,000 times $2. So our manufacturing margin is $4,000. Our variable operating expenses now are $1,000. Because it was 1,000 units times dollar per unit. So our contribution margin is $3,000. And our total fixed costs are $1,400 still, like they were last month. But now our income from operations is $1,600. So in this case, the variable income is $120 higher than the absorption income. And the reason being, under absorption, that $120 that we had in inventory now comes out, whereas under variable, that $120 from the units that we pulled in inventory, the fixed cost that we pulled out of inventory, that came out last month when we actually manufactured them. But remember, while variable costing may be beneficial for management analysis, it is not allowed for external reporting. It does, however, give the manager the advantage of cost control.